najekskluzivniji event za vrijeme Grand Prix u Monaku Amber Lounge Fashion i ove godine okupio brojne zvijezde koji su se priključili akciji prikupljanja sredstava za humanitarnu organizaciju Autism Rocks, koja glazbom pomaže djeci koja pate od autizma. Ovogodišnje najveće iznenađenje bio je pjevačka zvijezda John Newman, čiji je hit Love Me Again osvojio brojna srca diljem svijeta, a nama je u ekskluzivnom intervju povjerio kako je upravo njegovo slomljeno srce bio povod da nastane ovaj svjetski hit. Hey John, so song Love Me Again, it's about breakup. Are you more inspired when writing a song with the sadness or happiness?
I don't know. It's hard to hear a song that's a good song that's got happiness in it, isn't it? I think the key thing to do is, if you are about to write about happiness, explain why with sadness almost. My first album was about a breakup. This new album that I'm currently here promoting and starting to put my face back in the scene is again about sore moments, but again I think that's the important thing, taking something bad and making it good.
Hitom Love Me Again, John Newman zasio je na prvo mjesto top ljestvice u preko 16 zemalja svijeta, a pjesma ima skoro 300 miliona klikova na YouTube-u. No da li su svjetska slava i uspjeh bili dovoljni da zaliječe slomljeno srce?
And how did it react the girl once she heard the song? Have you managed to get her love back, or you didn't even care in that moment?
I think she definitely regrets it, yeah.
That's good, so you made a good point. It's unforgivable, a stolen branch of
soul, is that what demons do? Ovaj 24-godišnji britanski pjevač, kojeg nazivaju novom svjetskom soul senzacijom, tako se ovim singlom upisao na listu brojnih poznatih umjetnika koji su neke od najvećih svjetskih hitova stvorili u najcrnijim ljubavnim trenucima, poput Amy Winehouse ili Adele, s kojima ga često i uspoređuju.
Is it even possible to get a good song without, you know, some sad love?
I'm probably speaking for a lot of artists now and a lot of songwriters, and I think music is a thing that you do to express yourself. When you're down, it's a way of letting it out, you know? There's something about how people call their friends, or we're now in new social kind of media websites and things, and the reason people post things on them is to let it out, to let it go, to let it off their chest. Maybe it was a letter to people before, and I guess that's what music is now, that if I have an issue with somebody, if I have a problem that's been getting me down, the best way is to get it out of my body, and for me that's music. So yes, it is a musical release, and yes, sad moments are the key moment of that, I guess, to be able to express it. So.
Uz ljubavne jade, Newman je imao teško djetinjstvo. Njegovu majku, brata i Johna, otac kojeg ne želi ni spomenuti, napustio je kada je John imao samo 6 godina, te ih je ostavio doslovno bez ijedne funte. Dugogodišnja borba da se profilira u glazbenoj industriji u jednom je trenutku bila pala na drugo mjesto, kada mu je prije nekoliko godina otkriven tumor na mozgu.
You succeeded, you beat the disease. I've heard in some of your interviews that actually, you know, when you were in the hospital, you've heard your song on the radio for the first time. Can you tell me something about that moment?
Look, everyone goes through problems. Everyone's got bills to pay and things like that. And yes, I did have a growth in my brain area. But look, it's a thing that's, it's life, and life is life, and you've got to walk away from something like that with a positive attitude. And I have worked every day since then. I've done what I've wanted to do every day since then, and I've been stubborn, I've been hard to work with, but I get what I want, and that makes me very happy because I work for that. But yeah, you got to take them things as a positive. Can't be sleeping, keep on waking without the woman next to me. Guilt is burning, inside I'm hurting,
Veliki glazbeni hitovi donijeli su mu svjetsku slavu i gostovanje u nekim najpoznatijim TV showovima. Bez obzira na to, nije veliki fan celebrity industrije koja često u isti koš trpa velike talente i reality zvijezde koje svakodnevno pune novine privatnim skandalima.
Having so much fame at the moment, how do you balance staying normal and, you know, having so much media pressure, I would say?
I am quite lucky. I mean, and there's definitely people that bring it on. There's a lot of celebrities that will roll around on the floor on drunken nights to let paparazzi take pictures and, you know, spend hours on red carpets, which I tend to avoid. I think the reason is because I'm quite self-conscious. But to me, I'd never want to do anything that was to affect my music. I'm so proud of my music. I love making it, and that's the key thing. So I wouldn't want to ruin it by pushing my face over newspapers and everything too much. I mean, it's nice to give people this, but never too much.
Mišljenje da ima previše celebritija, a premalo umjetnika, Joe Newman nije veliki fan talent showova i čitave te industrije koja danas izbacuje pjevače kao na traci.
I think it's a brilliant business idea, and I wish I came up with that idea myself. There's a man behind it all that is very clever, I think. And I think we know who I'm speaking about when we say that. He's a very clever man, and what a brilliant business idea. Yes, people might be played a little bit, but maybe they're not. We'd never know. Beneficial, but also not good.
Za kraj nisam mogla da ne postavim ovoj mladoj zvijezdi pitanje na koje pjevači često izbjegavaju dati odgovor.
What do you think, what was the best song ever made?
I don't know, it's hard. I think it was an era for me more than a song. I think in the times where soul music was around in the 60s, there were some ridiculous songs. But the best song for me is probably A Change Is Gonna Come by Sam Cooke, and it was re-sung by Otis Redding.
I was born by the river in a little tent. Oh, and just like the river I've been running.
John Newman svojim je nastupom u Amber Lounge-u pomogao prikupiti 260.000 eura za Autism Rocks. Tome su pripomogli i vozači Formule 1 koji su na jednu noć postali manekeni.
How did you prepare? Did you practice? Did anyone help you, you know, to do a catwalk? Were you practicing maybe in hotel?
No, that's all. I just came here. Let's see how it goes. Maybe it goes wrong, but I didn't prepare so much for that.
Do you visit fashion shows? Do you go to fashion weeks or no?
No, I don't do very often. I never been, to be honest, in a fashion show. I just do photos in magazines like GQ and that kind of magazines.
Drivers always do the catwalk, you know, Lewis Hamilton, Jenson yes. Button, a lot of them. So, in your opinion, who is the best model of them?
Oh, you're putting me on the spot here. I love them all, but I love Nico the most, I would say, because he's from Monaco, so I have a
he would be the best
Nico. I mean, for me, I love Nico.
So have you got any interesting advice for the catwalk tonight?
Well, as I'm not the professionist for this, I obviously need to ask for some advice. So I ask you, you have some experience on that? Or?
Well, I do, yeah. But I think you seem pretty confident. I don't think you will have any problems. Have you seen your colleagues previous years? Who was, in your opinion, the best model of your colleague driver?
Of my colleagues? Jules Bianchi. So I send all my memories in regards to him. I was here last year and we shared a good moment. And we are all praying for him. You know, he's fighting for his life and, at the moment. Yeah, he's. I think he was very charismatic and very nice in the way he was doing it.
Mladi francuski vozač Jules Bianchi u teškom se stanju nalazi od 10. mjeseca prošle godine kada je doživio veliku nesreću nakon sudara s dizalicom u utrci Velike nagrade Japana. Stanje mu se popravlja vrlo sporo, kao i u slučaju Michaela Schumachera, čija borba traje već 17 mjeseci.
Michael represents a lot for our sport. You know, he achieved things that no one has achieved. in the history of Formula One. You know, for me, it's important that we, the drivers, always share a great moment in the present, that we really think about not only our profession, but also to share an experience, you know, because at the end of the day, we are all traveling together. And you never know what can happen to any of us the following day.
Uz formulaše reviju su nosile i hrvatske manekenke koje su prošetale kupaće kostime poznate dizajnerice Melise Odabaš i luksuzne večernje haljine slavnog Julian McDonalda koji je za Monako pripremio limitiranu skupocjenu kolekciju.
Well, you know, Monte Carlo is unique because it's a catchment, a tiny place where the most richest and the most glamorous people live. So they buy the most expensive clothes, they wear the most expensive glamorous, and this place you see a lot of crazy fashion of people with so much money they can buy whatever they want.
No vratimo se mi našim vozačima koje smo izrešetali s još nekoliko pitanja kako bi se što bolje opustili pred reviju.
How do you control yourself when you privately drive a car not to go too fast?
I mean, it's easy. When you are in the road, you need to take care because it's a lot of people on the road, then you cannot, it's not a racetrack. If you crash there, you can do a big crash and then it's not nice, no?
So you handle it good, huh?
I try to handle as good as possible, but it's not easy sometimes.
There's here a lot of wives and girlfriends of the drivers. Would you like that one day your wife or your girlfriends do the catwalk?
Well, there is a good purpose behind this event, and that's why I wouldn't mind, to be honest. Unfortunately, at the moment, I don't have a girlfriend, so...
Jedna od najatraktivnijih gošći večeri koja je ujedno i nosila modnu reviju bila je Jessica Button, supruga proslavljenog vozača Formule 1 Jensona Buttona, koja nam je ekskluzivno povjerila kako je izgledao njezin prvi susret s Jensonom. Was it love at first sight?
We actually met in Tokyo, Japan. He did have a very good impression on me, but we started off as friends. Yeah.
Recently you got married, so congratulations. It was in Hawaii. How was it?
No, it was a beautiful, beautiful day. We obviously try to keep it as private as possible, but yeah, it was a beautiful day.
Ova japanska manekenka i slavni vozač u vezi su od 2009. godine, dok se ona još aktivno bavila manekenstvom u Japanu sa ambicijom da izgradi svjetsku karijeru.
Well, before I met Jensen, I had absolutely no idea about racing whatsoever. I'm not, you know, a car person. I have no idea about, you know, technical stuff. But I got to know F1, and it's very fascinating. It's a very different world from where I come from. But yeah, it's all good. It's fun.
Osim u Jessicu, muške oči bile su uprte i u seksipilnu Viktoriju Silvstedt, bivšu Miss Švedske i model Donje Grublja, koja rijetko kada zaobilazi najpoznatija jet set okupljališta, a nama je otkrila da li je pobornik vježbanja i zdravog života.
I do what I like, which is fun. You know, I'm not like an extreme like workout girl, but I like to move. I like to, sometimes yoga, sometimes power walk, sometimes tennis. And when I travel a lot, I just run at airports carrying heavy luggage, you know, so, and like moving a lot, you know, but I'm not really in a special routine, but, you know, I try as much as I can to get my beauty sleep. I think it's the most important thing.
You know, I spoke with John Newman before, and actually he told me that one of the best songs he wrote was when he was heartbroken. How do you act when you're heartbroken? Were you ever heartbroken?
Heartbroken once. My first love. You know, I think we've all been heartbroken. And you think stand of the world and you don't think there's you will ever be happy ever again. But you know, time do heal all wounds, I must say, but you don't believe it at the moment.
Tako nam je Viktorija kao i uvijek podijelila i pokoji savjet o muško-ženskim odnosima.
I'm in a relationship, I'm very happy, I have a lot of fun, laugh a lot. I think the most important thing is like if you have fun together and just really good friends as well, and like you don't really necessarily have to like all the same things, but as long as you have a good laugh, for me, like humor is the most important thing, because if you don't laugh together, what's the point after, you know, when the passion kind of runs down a bit, like what do you got, you know?
Nadam se da ste uživali u ovoj predivnoj glamuroznoj noći iz Monte Carla, a u mojem sljedećem javljanju moći ćete vidjeti ekskluzivni intervju sa zvijezdom legendarne serije Games of Thrones, Liamom Cunninghamom.